Stories really do matter. How do I know? Well, you go to the movies to hear about the story. You read a book. When you get to know somebody, you want to know their story. Where have they come from? How did they get to where they are? And I want to share just a little bit of my story so that you can understand who I am, where I've come from, and how did I get to where I am today. You see, I was the firstborn daughter of a German family in Northwest Kansas, and I was raised with a work ethic. Neither one of my parents had graduated from high school, so I learned how to work really hard. And if someone else could do it, of course I could do it. I simply had the confidence to go out and make it happen. I did that all the way through school, through college, taking ridiculous numbers of hours plus working. And I thought, wow, I can set goals and I can reach them, and I can set goals and I can reach them. That became a pattern, and it's called overachiever. But because I could do it, I didn't think there was a problem. I didn't think it was so bad when every now and then I'd just have to crash for an entire weekend to catch up. That was just normal. Well, somewhere around age 12, 13, I discovered that God was speaking to me, and He called me to something really special. I remember sitting on a bale of hay west of the farmhouse, and I felt like God said, "Cheryl, I've called you to be a wise, beautiful woman of God." My little brain thought, wisdom, I just won't have to study and school will be easy. Beauty, Well, that was in the years of long, floaty blonde hair. Say that one quickly. And gorgeous tans. Well, as you can see, I have curly hair and I don't tan very easily. So I kind of thought He missed that one. Woman, I was female, so I had that one taken care of. I knew God. So He got 3 out of 4. I thought that was pretty good. And I just thought that meant I would have life pretty easy and I wouldn't always know what to do. Well, that overachiever, that overconfidence, that I wouldn't have to figure anything out, completely crashed when in my early 30s, after Forrest and I had been married for a year, we had this beautiful baby. Before Anna was born, the pregnancy was a disaster. I was in bed for 7 months. Of course, I overworked even in bed by sewing and making all kinds of outfits that would beautifully match whoever this child might be. But the pregnancy was hard. The delivery was hard. And afterwards, I didn't know then what I know now. I know that there was major candida, major hormonal issues. I went through depression, and I one day looked in the mirror and said, "You're not wise. You're not beautiful. You're nothing but a failure. You can't be. There's no way you can be a good wife or a good mother. If you were just out of the picture, then Forrest could marry someone who would be a good mom to Anna." And so I attempted to kill myself through pills. Fortunately, that didn't work, and Forrest came home and took me to the hospital. And after that, it's hard when you're dealing with depression because people think, well, you just didn't pray enough, and what if it's contagious? Maybe we should just avoid her. During that time, we also lost a business. I couldn't work. We lost our home. We lost a car. We lost everything. I had this beautiful little baby, and I had no clue how to nurture because it wasn't a job. It wasn't a project to conquer. But fortunately, because we were blessed with an amazing community all those years ago, someone suggested I begin to work with a nutritionist. Well, I thought they were strange, and he was a little unusual, but he got my attention when he said, "Cheryl, your stressful lifestyle has brought you to where you are. If we don't change that, the future doesn't look very good." So being the person that I am, I did exactly what he told me to do. Exactly. And from that very simple beginning, that led me to discover, wow, there's things you can do for your health. You can change how you eat. You can work with supplements. And I became a master at that. That's what led to changing my career from the computer industry into the wellness industry, into getting several degrees, my naturopathic, master herbalist, working with homeopathy, all kinds of credentials, all kinds of accolades that said I could do that. But I found that no matter what credentials you got, once you started working with people, the game changes because everybody is different. Tens of thousands of clients, writing books, being on television all over the country, put put me into a flagship position. People knew who I was. People knew what I did. They said, well, if Cheryl says it's okay, it's okay. So I took that responsibility seriously. I looked for the patterns. Why did it work here and why did it not work there? And over time, I discovered, wow, there's so many variables that the average practitioner misses. Your background, your beliefs, your perceptions, how your brain functions, your food. Do you like to cook? Do you hate to cook? Do you like to take supplements? Do you not like to take supplements? Maybe swallowing is an issue. There's so many variables. The more I learned about the brain, the more I realized that any approach must be perceived as easy by this part of your brain, your subconscious. So over the years, I've dealt with many health challenges, not just back in my 30s, but at 50 with menopause. Oh my goodness, how did my body change shapes almost overnight? Where did that belly come from? And oh, the girth around my waist and not sleeping. I've gone through that. You see, when you work with somebody with something as important as your health, remember that their story tells you what they've come through and what they understand about a journey and to go from where you are to where you want to be. So my story is to help you understand I've been through some challenges, health, financial, relational, business. I've been through it and I've come through it and I've learned what it takes to come through it and how to help others go through their journey to go from where they are to where they want to be. In as easy a way as possible so that it works with your brain, in an affordable way. So as you look for someone to be a mentor, to be a coach, to help you with your health, your business, your family, my story, it's brought me to where I am. I'm thankful for that story, but I'm also thankful that I didn't get stuck permanently at any of those places in the past. Coming through means that you too can have hope. There is a way through. There is an easy next step. And my role is to take your hand and help you discover it for you so that when you're in your 60s or 70s or 50s or 40s, wherever you might be, just realize that those decades slip away very quickly and becoming who you are is a choice. Be intentional. Be your very best you. Let someone walk beside you. And may you join a community that will support you all along the process, for that has certainly helped me. Yes, today, in my 60s, late 60s, I am so thankful for where I came from, what I've been through, and how I